Beautiful love. Well, it's the 18th of March 2022 and it's a beautiful sunny day, the hottest day of the year so far in Plymouth, and I'm going to go from Commercial Wharf through Sutton Harbour to Queensland's Battery, so let's go. So we're just going past Plymouth and Devon School Sailing Association. So from Commercial Wharf, I'm going to go past Bertie's and Gertie's food parlour. We can get some really nice penines and ice creams handmade. So we've got Gertie's on the left and Bertie's on the right. Bertie's is the ice cream parlour and the penines is for Gertie's at the moment. The Boathouse Seafood Cafe and Bar Takeaway catches their own fish in their own trawler first thing in the morning. This jetty you can get on Plymouth Cruises and also get the taxi, water taxi to Mountbatten. Just passing the Admiral McBride pub where the original Mayflower steps are, supposedly under the foundations. This is the dedicated monument area for the Mayflower steps and the Pilgrim Fathers. Famously where 400 years ago the Pilgrim Fathers set out to discover the world. Just across the water there you've got Queen Anne's Battery, which is where we're heading today. To the left we have Plymouth Tourist Information. As we pan to the right we're going to be looking at Captain Jasper's and Sutton Harbour. Ahead of us we've got the Tangle Lock and Walkway and the National Marine Aquarium in the background. This is the famous Plymouth Prawn. So we're just going over the footbridge and the lock gate to head towards the National Marine Aquarium in Teats Hill. The Rockfish is a great restaurant just at the side of the National Marine Aquarium with a ready supply of fresh fish, probably from the National Marine Aquarium, just next door. I'm now heading towards Teats Hill Housing Estate, heading towards Queen Anne's Battery. This is Teats Hill Rangefinder, a viewfinder that overlooks the local area. So we're just passing this ambulance, and it reminds me of all the great work that the National Health Service and all the support workers have done during the COVID crisis. They all deserve a medal. So here we are at Queen Anne's Battery, so let's take a look around. On the entrance, you've got fourth floor chandlery. In the boundaries of Queen Anne's Battery, there's a fitness gym where you can have a free trial fitness session, I believe. Just walking into Queen Anne's Battery now, where you can be impressed with some very luxurious boats and speedboats. Just walking over to Queen Anne's Battery from Plymouth Barbican. It's just like a fresh air, pure escapism. You can pretend that you're on one of these boats sailing in the Mediterranean somewhere, or even more exotic places like the Caribbean. This walkway overlooks Mount Batten and also has great views of Plymouth Barbican, where you can see the boats close up as they go sailing by. Morning. This boat's dredging out the harbour. There's a restaurant and bar at Queen Anne's Battery where you can get fine food and drink. And also there's like a nice drink. now seeing this catamaran trawler coming out of the lock, which is a tidal lock to Sutton Harbour. This is the Barbican to Mount Batten water taxi. It costs about £3 each way to get to the ferry, I think. Mount Batten is famously where Lawrence Arabia had his last posting in the RAF. Thanks for joining me on my short walk from Commercial Wharf, Plymouth Barbican, to Queen Anne's Battery, which is part of Southern Harbour Holdings. Special thanks to the music maker. 30 years of culture and the arts as a free service on Love Summertime TV. Don't forget to friendly share my videos, subscribe to my channel and support me through PayPal at ccsphoto1@gmail.com. Thanks for watching the video.